A lot of thought has gone into, in a sense, the reveal of Bella as a bride.
It is the big costume of the movie, and I did want to reveal it in stages until finally when she's seen Edward and walks down the aisle, you get the whole vision of it.
What I liked about the wedding dress is that they had ingredients to be revealed. That was not just a dress, that it had the bag that reveals the bag. It had elements that would allow us to slowly be putting pieces together.
Stephanie Meyer had lots of ideas about the wedding dress. Of course, she created it in her book, and she had always thought of Carolina Herrera as the designer of that dress.
She had very specific details that she wanted to use in this wedding gown.
Carolina Herrera is my favorite, and I really wanted the dress to be something that really special, not something that you're going to see every day, not a dress you would go and pick up at a store somewhere.
I sought an inspiration a little bit from the 20s, but it has to be for now.
Together, Stephanie and I collaborated with Carolina Herrera, and they created this beautiful white bias-cut satin dress.
The lace is especially designed for that dress, which is the extravagant detail in the back of the dress, which is a very important detail.
It's got a very dramatic back, which is kind of cut out with beautiful lace overlays. I think Stephanie wanted it to be extremely simple, not overdone.
I love what they did with it. They just came up with a really stunning concept. It's similar to what I envisioned, but then they sort of add in their own elements. It turned out beautiful.
Considering how much pressure and weight has been put on this dress, it was really scary right up until it fit perfectly.
She really loved it, I think. And so it was about something that was going to be beautiful and that would fit Kristen perfectly. And I think that's where we ultimately landed.
The most important is to please the bride because she's going to wear it. And when she tried the dress on at the end, she was very moved by it.
I think it's beautiful. I love it.
Which it was fabulous for me. Because I saw the job was done.
I now pronounce you husband and wife.
We started in Brazil, so the movie started with the honeymoon.
Shooting in Rio was really an experience.
Brazil is kind of chaotic, but it was the most amazing environment.
Like visually stimulating stuff, it was great.
It makes for a nice location change from cold, rainy Forks, Washington.
There were tons of challenges, you know, shooting in Brazil and in a condensed time frame.
When you've only got 3 or 4 days in a certain location, and every minute and every hour is so vital.
So if it was rainy one day, we had to go inside and shoot them making breakfast. If it was sunny, we ran up to the tops of waterfalls and did all of that stuff that will make audiences feel they've had the idyllic honeymoon.
The first day was actually Lapa. That's the scene where Bella and Edward get out of the car and walk through the streets. And that was really exciting because to kind of stage this party that took on a life of its own, basically.
I said to Bill, what if we actually found the place where these kids go? Where, like, if it was New York, we'd be in the East Village. We wouldn't be on the Upper East Side. If it was Paris, we would be in the 18th. We wouldn't be in the 2nd. So when these kids in Brazil actually see this movie, they're gonna look and they go, ah, Lapa. They got it right. This is where we go.
Eu fiquei com medo porque eles não virem para cá filmar, né? Porque eles podem muito bem fazer um cenário em qualquer outro lugar.
Um país maravilhoso com paisagens perfeitas.
Acho que nenhum filme nunca retratou isso antes. Nunca passaram essa realidade para lá. É bem diferente.
Muito apaixonada, apesar da idade, sou igual um adolescente.
Toda jovem adolescente sonha em ter aquele vampiro que te faz perder o fôlego quando você o vê, que sinta aquelas pernas bambas, o coração partindo, sabe, batendo mais acelerado.
Se você encontrasse com ele, o que você faria pra ele?
Não sei, eu...
se eu os visse, eu pediria um beijo de cada um no rosto. Acho que eu não ia conseguir ficar em pé.
The outpouring of love of the fans in Brazil. It's unbelievable.
They were great, you know. I think they were very respectful. People would still be drinking and dancing between setups and obviously when the camera was off. And it was a really magical way to start the movie.
No anoitecer, e a gente vai até o cair da noite.
Back room!
So we're not staying in Rio?
No, just passing through.
Okay.
Is it not all the way, or is it maybe it's not all the way in part?
Yeah.
Cut. Good. Forward.
Forward.
Going up the scene.
I didn't really learn how to drive it. I went for a lesson and crashed the practice boat. And then I went to Brazil and crashed the Brazilian boat too.
Go forward again.
Yeah, I drive a boat all right. I went to a lesson.
Let it idle forward.
I am definitely not nautical.
God.
But it was really fun. After a couple of takes, I very much considered just leaving in it.
Action.
That was a 5-hour highway road trip.
Winding coast of Brazil, it's beautiful. You see a lot of countryside.
We went to this adorable little town called Parati.
Taking something that comes out of someone's imagination and then making it connect to reality, that was really fun. It felt very satisfying.
All right, here we go. Camera.
Mark B. Mark.
Set, in action!
I win.
The first couple of days we got there were amazing.
The weather was great. The water was like turquoise. It was beautiful. It was gonna be perfect.
And then almost everything that could go wrong went wrong.
Started at 8, 9 in the morning. The weather seemed somewhat consistent and the weather was stable.
And roll sound.
You realize how many eggs you've gone through since you got here?
Yeah, my appetite's been crazy.
Mid-afternoon, the wind started to pick up.
We didn't have a forecast that was gonna tell us that it was gonna be this bad at all.
I'm starving.
Do you realize how many eggs you've had?
The weather started to turn for the worse at 6 in the evening. About 8:30 in the evening, Marine coordinator confirmed that it was starting to approach the point of no return and suggested that we wrap things up and get off the island. We immediately wrap it up and start heading down to the dock.
We're all going down to the docks and it was pouring down rain and everyone's covering up and they're like, we can't bring the boats in, turn around, go back. I guess about 120 of us had to spend the night on our set in this house, you know, kind of laying down tarps and sleeping on the floor. And I slept in a bathtub, I think.
Yeah, well, we went to Rio in the rainy season because we do stuff like that.
Hurricane force winds and monsoon rains. Seems fairly typical of honeymoons, really. If you put a lot of emphasis on a vacation, it ends up being pretty abysmal.
Ah!
are nothing if not traditional.
You see? Let's go again.
Okay, we'll come.
We started the movie. We structured it such that we would start with really Rob and Kristen, and as much as, you know, maybe almost a month of shooting, just with them.
You want to take a look around?
Bill really wanted to just be able to kind of focus in on the early stages of their relationship.
It was a really good, comfortable way for all of us to get to know each other.
Yes, it's true.
And I feel that with Rob, he's an incredibly charming guy.
We have to do that again. His elbow to his
Edward can sometimes be brooding and filled with doubt, but when he finally makes this leap and marries Bella and gets what he wants, you know, I thought there was just like a kind of charm and ease and a more of Rob Pattinson that he was willing to bring to the part.
Oh God.
And that was the most valuable time that we had.
Okay, good. Thank you. Very good.